DZ the double easy, another episode all about the semis. How about you, drivers? Yeah, man. Been home for about a week. I know it's been a little minute since I put some videos out. And usually, I told you guys I'm not gonna make videos while I'm home. I'm on my home time. But last week, 2 weeks has been hectic, and I stayed out 2 weeks and I didn't have time to make a video for you guys. So you're gonna get a treat today. Man, I got this duck doing up here in my house. What's going on, Mr. Duck? Y'all see that? Man. Oh, Mr. Ducky. Stand by. We gonna jump right into this. I holla at you. Yeah, man. So I'm been home for a couple weeks, and I've been home for a couple weeks. Been home since Tuesday, and it was an interesting week. It really was, man. And I tell you here, boy. Let me get my light adjusted right, y'all. Let's get this light adjusted. You know, I always be having issues with the light. There we go. Go ahead and lock that in. So, you know, it's been one of those weeks, man. And I'll tell you what. I had a crazy week. So stand by. So I'll pause this, get settled, and I'll be right back. Yeah, y'all. So, I had a crazy week, and let me figure out somewhere I can put y'all. Oh my God, this light is driving me bananas. You know, that's the thing about these automatic adjustments for these cameras. There we go. We're gonna lock it in. So yeah, you know, I had a crazy little, let me get this camera put on. I just went grocery shopping, y'all. I'm trying to put my food away and cook something at the same time. So, you know, you got to bear with your boy. So, I had an agent last week. It was crazy because I had ran a load from Newark to Michigan. And it was going to Chrysler dealer. The load was a good paying load. And I don't even know where to start. So this was last week before I, you know, took off. The daggone agent didn't tell me, you know, it was a shipment of batteries. It was batteries for Chrysler. And they told me that, you know, go there, pick them up, take them to the Chrysler dealer, drop it off, nothing for nothing. Mind you, in the midst of all that snow, and this is during a time where Texas was having their issues going on. So I get all the way up there and everything. And when I get there, the guy goes, oh, you got to unbolt this stuff from the floor. The agents never told me that. And I'm like, what do you mean? It was like, you gotta unbolt this stuff from the floor, you know, before we can take it out. So I go back in there and I looked, and I'll post the pictures, but there was like 30 pieces of wood nailed to the floor to keep the batteries bolted down. I said, they didn't tell me none of this. So I called the agent. The agent's like, yeah, if you guys want me to unbolt this stuff, you guys are gonna have to pay me for that. That's driver securement, you know, pretty much. And the lady goes, oh, we need you to get a BOL signed that it driver removal and all this and that. So I said, you guys didn't tell me none of this. If I had have known that, I'd have been prepared. Not mind you, I didn't have nothing to undo that stuff with because I wasn't expecting it. Make a long story short, my next load from there, which was under the same agent, was 3 hours away, pretty much 2.5 hours. And they already, knew that they wasn't going to unload that trailer like that. It just wasn't going to happen. So what happened was, sorry about that, guys. So what happened was, they turned around and gonna tell me, well, see what you can do. And no, I said, no, there's no see what you can do. I said, either you guys are gonna pay me for this or you not. I said, and keep in mind that your second load is my second load is your load. They're not gonna load this trailer. So Landstar gets involved. They tell me that they were going to pay, were going to pay me. I said, well, what kind of money we're talking? Because it's going to at least be an hour or so for me to get this wood out of here. Not to mention, I got a 2.5 hour trek. And then I'm going to be late. And is they're going to wait? Get all the way over there. I make it. I get the wood out over there because had I took the 1.5 hours to remove that wood here where I was, the place would have been closed. So luckily I got there and they were nice enough to wait for me to get the wood unnailed from the floor and get me loaded. And guess what the agent decides to do? They decide not to pay me after they told Landstar they were going to pay me. So I'm fighting that now. So now I just lost that plus the time. 1.5 hours that it took me to get the wood out, needless to say, crazy week. So I picks up my next load, which was taking me home, picked up in Newark, going to was a two stop and three stop in Florida, Panama City, and then it was Plant City, Panama City, and then up by Tallahassee, and I was bringing me home. Once I got up in the Newark, got the load dropped off, got stuck in the snow up there at a yard jockey had to pull me out. That was fun. I got video of that too. I might post it, I might not. It depends on how much editing I feel like doing. But yeah, it was a crazy week, man. And then on top of that, I was in Maryland the week prior, because mind you, I told you guys I stayed out for 2 weeks this time. So I was in Maryland picking up in Elkton, Maryland for an agent. I get there, they hold me up for 6 hours. I got there at 7 o'clock, which was my delivery time. I didn't get out of there till roughly about 3, 4 o'clock. It was crazy. That agent paid me though. He paid me on that. When I got to his receiver, the receiver held me up. And guess what? He didn't tell me when I got there that they loaded all the freight on the floor. And if you guys ever dealt with, if you guys, any of you guys ever dealt with getting your freight loaded on the floor of the trailer off the pallet, you know how long it takes them to load the truck. So I gets to the receiver, and guess what? Another 4.5 hours to get the truck unloaded. That was another nightmare. So I lost 12 hours. Nonetheless, that agent did pay me accordingly on the load. So I was pretty okay with that. And like I said, the following week, I ran into this thing with the auto parts delivery. The load I had coming home, though, for the next week, it was a great load. It paid $4,800, and it was probably just under a little over 1,500 miles or so, something like that. Really good paying load, like $4 a mile almost, and it set me up for home. So we did really good last week and the week prior. So we were good. So now I end up having to take this week off because I had to get the house together and do some things and whatnot. So That's pretty much it. I'm sorry if I rambled real quick. I was trying to give you guys a quick update on what's going on. And it's your boy QDZ, the double easy, and I'm out. More videos coming. I promise I will get better. And I'm looking at going out probably Tuesday and next week. So we will see how that plays out. Or I don't think Monday. I'm probably going to go out. I need to get the truck cleaned and get some stuff together with the truck. So probably going to be trying to get out by Tuesday. I'll keep you guys updated and I will let you know. Stay safe out there. Peace out.